Welcome, Leo, my beautiful lions. I'm Brenda, Brenda Tarot, and I'm here again today to bring you your weekly angel tarot and oracle reading for September the 16th to the 23rd, 2019. I truly again want to thank you for your interest in my channel and for viewing, liking, and clicking the thumbs up button and subscribing. And when you do subscribe, please click the bell button as well, because you'll get notified immediately when these are out on open air for you to view on YouTube. Again, this is only a general reading. Some of these cards will resonate with some of you Leos, and if it does, run with it and throw the rest out into the universe. If you want clarity, accuracy, and answers to any questions, then I invite you to click the little icon in the top right hand corner of this video, and it will take you into my website where you can see the services that I offer. All the other information is posted below this video. Let's get on with this. So right now we're dealing with what's coming in, what's above you, what's below you, what's behind you, and what's coming into you. This is where you are now. This is the earth of, the King of Earth, better known as the King of Pentacles. I love, love, love this card because I call this the Midas Touch card. No matter what you fall into, you're going to come up smelling like a rose. Things are going to work out. Success is going to happen. You're going to turn a situation around that's going to work out in your favor. It talks about you being in a very good place right now. This earth energy is amazing. And you know, you may have to take on the energy of this king. And you know what? This king, you know, he comes in and, you know, he's probably a Taurus, a Virgo, or a Capricorn, because this is an earth sign, you know, the Pentacle sign, and he's an earth energy, and you may have to take on the energy of stepping up and being a leader. But I do see it in business. I see a business leader here. Some of you may step up and be getting in touch with financial advisors this week. It's as though no matter what you do, you're being led by the universe and the divine to be exactly where you need to be, aligned on your path to bring in the abundance that you want. Okay. So I see that you're going to step up and you're going to be reliable. You're going to know what's best for you, and you're going to know how to wheel and deal an instinct for things to work out in your favor. So it's like you're the Rock of Gibraltar right now. Nothing's going to waver you. Nothing's going to knock you over. You're in a successful period of your life, and you need to enjoy what you're doing. And if you are successful, hey, don't feel guilty about it. Enjoy it. Coming in above you, what's coming in above you? You've been given the Star. This is amazing energy. You know that the Star, you know, is the best card in the whole deck. It's all about happy times, and this is not the card that goes with the Star, so we'll remove it. This has got mixed up here. There's the Star, and this goes here. So the Star is all about you knowing that things, again, like the King of Earth, coming above the King of Earth, you've got amazing gifts this week coming in, my Leos. So you're going to be able to make long-term and optimistic plans now, knowing that you're on the right path. You're going to get your chance to shine now. You're going to be able to get your chance to step forward and be noticed for what it is you do and who you are. This is your time to illuminate. This is your time to step up, okay, and lean into your prosperity. Lean into your goals and your happiness. You've got coming in below you the Ace of Earth. Again, another gift, the Ace of Pentacles. All about the inflow of abundance coming in. Being able to walk through the gate there and know that the horizon is on the other side. The grass is always greener, and you're going to go look for that. A promising business venture. We talked about that here with the King of Pentacles. You may be dealing with an earth sign when it comes to business this week. Like I said, a Taurus, a Virgo, or a Capricorn may be coming into play here. That's going to be paramount with how this falls into place. I do see that, you know, there may be signing of some important documents here with this Ace of Earth, with this particular earth sign. And, you know, you will be stepping up to collaborate and communicate with others when it comes to business. Wow. So we start off the week very, very well. What you left behind, you left behind the Three of Earth. And the Three of Earth and the Three of Pentacles here, we have three of them here, again, is the power of you being creative. And you are collaborating with others, communicating with others, picking other people's brains, being able to share information back and forth, sharing documentation back and forth, sharing your wisdom. And you're going to get recognized for your high quality work. And it's going to come in the form of, you know, perhaps some of you are going to get a raise, or you're going to get a promotion at work, or you're getting offered a different position, or someone is seeking you out to help you work yourself up that ladder. You, because you're a team player, and they know that. You have the ability to step up and know what it is you have to do, but you have the team, you're a team player. But you also have the ability with this king to be a leader. So you've been, you may be asked to step up, and you may have a team underneath you. Okay? What you need to expect. Well, you know what? You've been given the two of air, which is the two, what's coming, you know, what's coming into you. Basically, you've been given, you know, this two of air, the two of swords. And this is telling me that you may, you know, may find yourself in a situation this week where you don't have all the information that you need. And you need to take the blinders off, put the swords down, don't be so stubborn, and make a choice or a decision that's very paramount now. You can't put this on hold. You can't just sit there in limbo. You've got to move on it and act towards it, because it'll show me that you're at a stalemate right now. And pretending there's no problem isn't going to solve it. This is the card that I show you, the Locking of Horns card, two very opposite people. It is an air sign. It could have to do with legal ramifications. It could have to do with just justice situation. And I do see that you will be the one that'll put those swords down and be able to turn around and see that the waters are not that turbulent behind you. You have the ability to free yourself and make this choice and decision. So there may be something coming up that will decide your future for where you're going with your finances. And it could also be something where it has to do with a legal issue, a custody issue, a disbursement of property issue, you know, money therein. So I do see that you're going to be able to put those swords down, and you will be making this choice and decision this week. Now we're moving on to the Lenormand deck. And the Lenormand deck here, I'm going to tie in this way, and then I'm going to cross-reference. So the top of your reading here, you've been given the Faithful Dog. And, you know, it may have to do with this situation with you being a team player and having people on your team that are by your side. And one of them may be one very close individual that is always going to be there no matter what you do. You will have that ability to be with them. And they're going to be honest and forthright and upright and you know, an upstanding type of individual that was always and will always be in your end of the ring. They're very loyal. So you're very lucky this week with whoever this team is you're working for. They're very, very loyal to you. Coming in below you, you've been given the Child. So you may be dealing with situations here and having conversations and communicating with others about the welfare of a child. You know, again, this could be you tapping into your inner child, though, for some of you, knowing that you need to let go, you know, free yourself from all the seriousness of life and be able to have some fun. So you may be stepping up and letting your inner child come out. You may have some situations that have to do with dealing with children and issues therein. So I do see this as a happy card, though this isn't a card of sadness when it comes to this child. Now, moving here above the Two of Swords, you've been given the House. And this might be a situation here, because I talked about this maybe being a legal situation, locking horns with somebody, and it may have to do with the sale or the purchase of a house. And it may have to do with that. But I do see this is always something very emotional. This is a card that means happiness. You're going to have the stability of a home again. You're going to be protected, and you're going to have that foundation. It's a good card. Now, coming in below the swords is you've had your struggles. This is the mountain, but I always show everybody the picture of the little tiny deer at the bottom. And that deer knows that it has to process how it's going to maneuver its way and manipulate its way with its sure-footed hooves, how it's going to climb that mountain. And so it's processing that. It's thinking about it, just like you are here, thinking about this situation. But you're going to be able to make that decision. And you know what? You'll be able to get over this hurdle as well. Now, let's crisscross this. Okay, so you've got the Faithful Dog here coming in with the, you know, the center card here, which is where you are now with the King of Pentacles. All this is good luck. And it may have come into play because someone has been in your end of the ring that has helped you get to this point. This could be also your loyal friend here, the King of Pentacles. This could be that that Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn around you. It hasn't always been easy for you, but now you can clearly see that you're going to reach the pinnacle of that mountain. You're going to reach, you know, the top of the mountain. You're going to be able to reach the summit. Coming in here now with the Child and the Home. Okay, so you're going to have the finances now and the stability now to be able to restart with your home. You may be bringing a child with you into this home. Maybe you're going on your own and you've had to have some legal issues to deal with, but you're going to come out at the top. You're going to come out at the end of the day feeling successful. You will feel like you're back at home again. You'll feel at home, that feeling of feeling at home. Beautiful. Now, we're moving on to my brand new deck, which I haven't used before until this week. And they're called the Tea Leaf deck. And they're huge. There are a lot of cards. The card itself isn't huge, but there's a lot in the deck. And so what I've been using is I've been cross-referencing them here for the reading. And I asked my guides and spirit where I should place these. Left, right, and center. So where is the center? That's the center. Okay, left and right. Okay, let's see what they've given us here to cross-reference this reading. Well, right away, you've got new creative ideas, new ventures, and a fresh start. And it came in with this beautiful King of Pentacles. You know, you have the gift of the Ace of Pentacles, and you have the Star here. So the energy is continuing through this reading, my beautiful Leos, that you will have be able to see the sunrises come up, that you're going to be able to have new creative ideas coming into you. You're going to have the resources and all the time to make this all a happy occasion. Coming in on where you were, you've got the Cat. There may be a two-faced friend here. You may have had to have a discussion with someone here. This talks about someone who isn't totally honest. This is like the mask. They don't show you who they truly are, and then all of a sudden they surface. And so, you know, this is someone you're dealing with that isn't totally honest with you. So that's the only thing I have to say. You know, even though it came in here with the Child and with the Dog, the faithful person, there may be a third party here that came in. There's three people in this, and this is the Three of Pentacles. There may have been a third party here that was involved in some sort of situation right now that you're involved in that isn't so honest. So beware of that two-faced friend, so-called friend. Now, here with the Swords, the Two of Swords, you know, being locked in, you've been given victory. And this has to do with some endeavor you've been dealing with. So this is an excellent card. You're going to win out at the end when you make this decision that you have to make. So it will work in your favor, this decision. When this victory card comes up, you know, with this situation, the V, that means it's going to work out in your favor. So I'm happy with all this energy coming into you. The only one here is this third party that might have caused a problem here, and it might have been over money. Now, the final outcome card from the Answers from the Angels is perfect timing. And everything, I tell you this all the time, everything in life has to do with perfect timing. And, you know, we have to be patient. We have to wait. Sometimes we manifest, we pray, we want things, and we say, why hasn't it happened now? And we become doubtful and, you know, and we don't want to continue moving forward with a positive energy. But know that you'll be able to move forward this week. It's all about perfect timing, and things are working out right off the bat here. Your energy in the center of this reading was all positive with the King of Pentacles, the Midas Touch card. The Star is the best card in the whole deck, and you're getting this divine and universal gift from the Ace of Earth and the Ace of Pentacle card here, the inflow of abundance. This is a very good reading for you. You're going to have stability again. You have people here that are supporting you in your endeavor and where you're going. You know, nothing comes in easy in life. Of course, we have hurdles to climb. We have challenges to meet. But yours are going to turn out into a victory for you at the end of the day, at the end of the week. Well, my beautiful, beautiful Leos, my Lions, this is your reading for September the 16th to the 23rd. And again, I want to thank you, and I leave you with this. The universe and the divine, your higher power, want you to succeed and find your happiness and peace. So surrender to it and move forward towards your goals and your happiness. Blessings, my beautiful souls, and know that I stand only in this circle of love and light for you. See you soon.